Hi, welcome to Business Automated. Today I will show you how to quickly create and adjust dates in a Gantt chart using our script app. Let's get to it. Let's start creating a new Gantt chart completely from the scratch. So we'll create a new table, create the names for our tasks. What is essential in Gantt chart is that we also need to have a link to the successor tasks in our table. So we're going to link to the same table and we're going to be linking to other tasks here. So let's just copy the sample names of those tasks. We're going to call it successor. Now that each task has a successor, which needs to be executed after the first task is completed. The next field, we're gonna need to have some starting and finishing dates. We're gonna add duration in days, how many days does this task take. We're gonna make it a number format. And now we will add a button to run our script, but before we do that, let's just remove those columns. And let's use a new dashboard to create everything from the scratch. So the first step will be installing an application. We're gonna use a script, scripting app, install. You can get started with a template or just start from scratch with whatever there is. We're gonna delete everything here and we're gonna copy paste from the link that you will find below this in this video. We're gonna paste the whole script of the application. You don't need to worry about everything that is included here. What you need to know is that only the values that are marked here needs to be changed to be adjusted to your table. So as you can see, the first thing that we need to do is change the name of the table. So it's not gonna be table 2, it's gonna be table 2, not table 1. Then we're gonna select what is the starting date. In our case, it is called just start. And then the end, in our case, is called the end, just. So that's the end date. And then duration is day's duration. And then finally, we need to select what is the name of the successor task field. So it's gonna be successor. All right, so these are all the changes that are needed. Let's finish the editing. So you can actually test it from here and let's use this as a starting date and let's add some arbitrary durations. And we can start that script from here. You will see that it will automatically populate the dates already here, but let's add the Gantt chart to that. In most cases, it will get auto-populated. We need to know that we're selecting table 2, the default grid view. We will have to select the starting and the ending column. And then the label is going to be the task name in our case. And here we need to remember it's important to select whether this task is a successor or whether this is a predecessor. Predecessor means it would be linked differently. So in our case, we are selecting successor because that's what we have decided. And we are highlighting the critical path for the whole project to be concluded. So we're gonna do done, but let's just change it to a monthly view. And as you will notice on the monthly view, our script is avoiding weekends. So any weekends that are included here will not be included in the duration for the task that we are having. So you can see that, for example, task 2 consists actually of only 2 days, but because it's scheduled over the weekend, the script has extended the duration of the task for multiple days. You can also see that if we schedule this task on, let's say, Saturday, it would not be executed on, it would not start on Saturday, the script would move it. So let's start from the task 1. You can see that the script has actually pushed it to the first working day. So to make it easier for us to operate, let's just add additional column that will be run the script. We're gonna use the button. and we're going to select run a script. We need to select which dashboard, so dashboard 2, and we're going to select our scripting application. Alright, so you can see that, for example, if for whatever reason the date of starting for the second task has been delayed, and now we know that we will have to start it a week later, we can adjust the date for this module, which will automatically make it incompatible with the rest. So we need to click start here on the script, and it will push all the other records over here. The same way, if one of the tasks here in the middle changes duration, so for example this gets extended to 7 days, so we're gonna update from here, and then duration of this task as well as in all the successor tasks will be extended as well. Alright, I hope this is useful for you guys, and you can find the link to that script in the description of this video. And if you like this video, please subscribe to our channel for more automation videos. Have a good day.